And that's not going to be good. We got plus two melee on the way. The Spire's about to complete.
Looks like a very, very nice contaminate on that factory, helping to delay that tank count quite a bit. We see MMA trying to spread out. And this is an extremely bold play, having an orbital command at the gold expansion. Ooh. That is going to be a gigantic vulnerability. But if he can keep it up, it means his macro will be through the roof. And look at all the bunkers going down for MMA. We see Roaches moving cross-map right now. The layer is done. The Spire, more importantly, is going to be finished. So if any Mutalis pop up, we're going to see MMA have to be in a very, very tough defensive position. But it looks like no Mutalis are out yet. Lucira is going in for the attack.
Oh, yeah, and he's not going to attack even from one direction, but multiple directions. A lot of links do get hit there, and he's going to go in for a huge hit on the Baylings, looking for one he can take out from the top. Our Baylings rolling in. Tank's doing a ton of damage, and it does look like MMA. Will he be able to hold this off? The Roaches might do enough to clean it up, but there's still a few tanks sieged up there, and Losira's going to give it his all.
MMA defends, but Zerglings at the gold expansion managed to clean up a lot. The Banelings annihilate the remaining SCVs at that expo. And again, Banelings picking off those SCVs. In the unit counting station, we see 65 SCVs remaining for MMA, 95 for Losira. That does mean that Losira can easily re-macro and make bigger and bigger constant attacks. But MMA, not to be deterred, will be collecting those Hellions, going to try to find any point of vulnerability. But unfortunately, he goes to the fairly unpopulated gold expo, will get surrounded. Can he pick off some of these links?
He is going to take out a few of them, making a lot of them very, very hurt down to the red, but he will manage to take them off. Looks like we're going to have a few Marines come over there. They'll clean those up as well, too. And you can see that we are seeing MMA continue to try to push forward. The one bunker did survive. A lot of those did get taken out, but they also serve as those great sort of fence posts for those Banelings, trying to block them if they do come in. However, once again, we're seeing this very, very swarm-heavy type of an approach here to Zerg with Losira's play. 22 more Roaches on their way out. He is going to spot a medevac.
Uh-oh.
Or did he spot that medevac?
I don't think he did see that medevac, and with this brilliant sensor tower placement, all these multi-prong attack by Losira will all be predicted, but I don't think Losira even cares. He's going for it. All the tanks has amazing placement with the Banelings rolling in. Oh my god, so many Banelings annihilating everything. Losira seeming to have an endless drain of units, but can MMA defend for long enough? The drop at the gold is being unleashed, and Losira does manage to get defended, but oh, the workers at the expo all getting taken down. MMA still in the fight.
Yeah, a lot more of those SCVs transferring back to the gold, but there's still Links working on it, and he takes out the command center at the gold, rendering these SCVs somewhat useless as they'll have to now long distance mine all the way back. The Mutas are out on the field now. They're going to just start firing at that medevac, and they will manage to take it out, but we have another attack here in the main.
MMA lose the medevac, but that bottom expansion vulnerable to the spawning pool gets taken out. MMA suddenly sprinting forward with a big attack. Can Losira possibly find some way to defend with only Mutalis? No Zergling production possible. MMA sprinting forward, stimming, killing off all of these creep tumors. The Queen's vulnerable, will get taken out. MMA doing an amazing counterattack, the likes of which we have not seen all tournament long. Suddenly, Losira, who's been sending waves of max armies at the Terran player, is on the offensive. Losira on the back foot, cleaning up all the spine crawlers. MMA rebuilding the gold, nearly broke at the expo, nearly broke at the main.
And we are seeing that command center being rebuilt there at the gold. We're going to have another hatchery going down for Losira at the gold. He also has his hatchery completed on the south natural expansion. The Mutalis are going to make their way over to the gold. Might be able to take out that SCV, building that command center, which will delay it even more. And can he strangle MMA just enough to help limit that production that could come out and that crucial economy he needs?
Oh, getting some good hits off on those Mutalis. And in the meantime, the drop at the south end. He sees the Mutalis are at the north. There is no way to stop this drop from going on. Will he drop everything? MMA is going to drop a couple of Marines, but then is also going to head over to the bottom right. We see the Mutalis trying to swing back around. MMA finally reestablishing the gold and getting that key critical top left base. We see cleaning up on that bottom side, but MMA is getting covered from all angles.
And now MMA MMA, now getting the weapons level 3, keeping up on those upgrades. Packs of Marines moving out, and right now, Banelings would certainly be their friends, but there are still a ton of tanks here for MMA. That is a lot of tanks there. Sir Day, as we have 10 tanks moving out, and even though he has lost oh so many throughout this match, he is still looking good in those counts, inching ever so closer to Losira's main base.
And there's the siege. Losira correctly pulls back at the last second. We see there is another drop going off at the top. MMA delivering on his promise of aggression. There is the bottom expansion under heavy fire, and we see all of the Zerg units recollecting to deal with this drop that is going to go down up in the main. The south expansion has fallen, and we are seeing MMA, an aggressive mastermind, trying to find any possible opportunity he can, and it seems to be working.
Now, one thing that is interesting is MMA consistently moving these Marines off to try to pick off this and that. There's been a couple. Oh, look at that. You're in the middle. Okay, that's okay. I don't care. I'm going for the gold. He's going to lift up. Links are going to stream in, start working on those SCVs. Meanwhile, the rest of the army moving back. A lot of tanks on siege right now. Bermuda's going to move in. Bailey's killing nearly all of them. And it is just a few Marines and a few tanks left over on that. Mutas are going to gauge again. Then they move back. His muta count is falling, but a good solid Baneling hit on those Marines that are left would put MMA behind. Right now, he went from 10 tanks down to just 4 tanks, 11 mutas out, 6 Banes, 39 Lings, and right now 79 drones for Losira.
And it looks like yet another drop going on by MMA. They seem nearly suicidal. No way the Mutalisks won't be able to kill those off, but MMA doesn't care. He is trying to ramp up the aggression, and it is preventing Losira from taking more expansion. Losira occupied down at the south, a drop going on in the main, and MMA using this opportunity to make another push at the Gold Expo.
Right now, Losira is putting most of his units here into the gold, and I wonder if we're going to see MMA just try to leap forward, trap his opponent in there. It's not going to happen. Losira playing a dangerous game, but it were working out pretty good. Comes in from behind with the mutas, takes out one tank. Oh no, loses a lot of mutas in there, but does roll in if he can take out this big cluster of Marines. A huge pickup in the medevac, saving several of those Marines, and they have been his saving grace. We got another drop here in the southeast, and Lings are going to stream in with the medevac. Will he have enough healing? We got a couple mutas moving over, going to try to take care of that, but there's 4 Marines in the back. They could get a lot of drone kills. The Zerglings are now gone, and they're going to try to help out taking these Marines, and action all over the map.
MMA, I cannot believe we are seeing a Terran so good, so aggressive. Losira having endless streams of units. MMA doesn't care. Losira moving in for a counterattack. 2 dropships going into the main. MMA taking a big hit on all of those Marines, but stimming, going for the jugular. There's the drop, gonna kill the pool off one more time. The top left, all the SCVs are dying. In the natural, the gold, all the Lings are killing off all the workers. The pool falls again. If MMA can hold this off, he will win the game.
Wow.
That is the most impressive Terran play I have ever seen. MMA trying to utilize that style early in the tournament, losing games with sloppy play. But we've heard that story so many times before, that the more aggressive you are, the more focused you have to be, the more you have to make sure you're not going to cause your own loss. Now that MMA's had that rest, he hasn't had to play as many matches today. He is focused, he is on, and is doing the most impressive job of picking apart a massive, massive Zerg lead.
It was really impressive from all of the drops from the dual factory that came out that was scouted by Losira, and he still wasn't able. I mean, you saw that he had the what he thought was going to be enough to deal with, trying to use the Overseer, stop the production on that. But it seemed like once MMA started to take claim of that middle area, that's when we really saw the breakdown there. It was tough for Losira to make his way in. And, I mean, with all the epic counterattacks and epic drops that were going on, there was really so much multitasking happening in that match. It's almost hard to process how these players are able to do such amazing things.
I mean, the dropship, the medevac control by MMA was the most oppressive part of that game, I thought, because ordinarily you try to force the medevac to work.
You try to make sure it does a bunch of guaranteed damage. You try to see the Mutalisk over at the left side of the map. Okay, I'll drop at the right. Or I'm doing a push through the middle, and then I'll do a drop along the backside.
Right.
However, what we saw MMA do was just send Medivacs away. Mutalisk and Zerglings were there, killed off the Medivac, killed all eight Marines off. Seemingly a wasted investment, no damage done, but it meant that all of Losira's units were on the defensive side,
yes.
So that huge push ended up being ridiculously powerful.
And then just the instant reaction and what you said during that broadcast, where the Mutas are on one side of the map, perfect opportunity to drop in through the bottom. It seemed like every single time that MMA saw those opportunities, he was going right in and achieving exactly what he wanted to achieve there. So it looks like MLG Metalopolis is going to be our next map.
Yeah, again, a very, very, very popular Zerg map. But I mean, if you're Losira, how do you possibly mentally recover from a game like that where you had four hatches so fast? You shut down those blue flame Hellions. They did almost nothing. You got your gold up really quickly. Everything was going in Losira's favor, but MMA making the units that everyone else makes but doing miracles with them.
Well, we're going to be setting